Hello and welcome to Kittrick Farms. We're back with another episode of Elm Creek. And today we're going to wrap up the seeding that we had going on here. I've come up here to the store here to get a pallet of dry fertilizer. We need to get this brought back up to the farm. We ran out while we were trying to wrap up our seeding here in the last episode. So we're going to grab this and get that seeding knocked out. We've got a field and a half left to do here. All right, we're out here. We've got just a little bit of these oats left to go here, so we're gonna get this tractor all fired up, get it warming up, and it looks like we can put the whole container here of our dry fertilizer into the seeder. So I'm gonna just get this truck pulled back up here into the yard out of the way so we're not running into it when we're turning around and stuff. We also don't want to forget it and leave it out in the field again. And at some point I would love to pick up a second tractor here for the farm so that we could be setting up for our next job. We've got a lot of jobs going on here on the farm. We could already be getting our seeder set up, or I'm sorry, our sprayer set up to go knock out some acres of spray in here. We are gonna try, I think, and apply herbicide to all of our fields here soon. And so we've got just lots of running around to do. But with the size of our farm right now, we're kind of limited to hitting things with this one tractor and doing jobs one at a time here. So we'll see about expanding the farm here soon. I've got my eye on a couple of upcoming tractor mods that I think would be a good fit for our farm here. So we'll have to wait until those get released and check those out. So we've wrapped up this field here. It looks like we've got just enough seed probably to tackle this other field, I'm hoping. We've got a little bit difference in color in the soil here because when we join these two fields together, this darker part up here, I believe it wasn't already fertilized. And so we were applying the fertilizer to this side of the field versus the back side of the field here, which was already at the maximum fertilizer level. So I think that's kind of why the soil looks a little different there. Now I'm gonna leave this tractor parked up here on this other field real quick right here. We're not quite ready to put the seed in here for a couple of reasons. One, we got a ton of rocks out here, so the way that FarmSim's set up, I think we need to roll these rocks so that we're not doing damage to our equipment. However, I think this is a direct drill, so this might also be digging up rocks and having those pop up, so I don't want to have to do it twice. We might actually just take the damage to the seeder so that we only have to roll things once. We're also going to be putting our soybeans in here, and so if we look at the planting calendar here for soybeans, we've got to get into April for that. So I'm gonna go ahead and set this thing up for the soybeans so that I don't forget a little bit later on here, and we're gonna run back up to the farm and advance time forward a day. All right, so we've got 2-day seasons enabled here, so I had to move forward 2 days to get from the month of March to the month of April. I keep saying 2-day seasons, I really mean that we've got 2-day months enabled. So we're gonna run back out here to the field and get this field knocked out. We've got some rain in the forecast, so we've gotta go, go, go. We're gonna start off here taking the headlands off here, getting them all set up. It's really hard to see that we're seeding at all right now. If we bring up the map here, you can see we're actually seeding onto the field here. And as we're going the other way here, you can see the texture's a little bit easier to see. It's just for whatever reason, when we were taking that first pass, it was lining up in a way that it was really hard to tell where we were going. And you can also see our oats came up right away here, which is awesome. So all of our other crops are well into the growth stage. We've got to just get these soybeans into the ground here, and we will be all done with our seeding for the year, and we'll be able to jump into the spraying season, which is going to be fun. We've got the new sprayer here that I've been looking forward to trying out, so we're going to have to definitely give that a shot here quickly. I'm beginning to wonder if we're going to have enough seed here or not for this field. We're already at 21%. However, it looks like we're using less volume of seed per distance driven with this implement for soybeans than we were for the oats. So, I don't know. I think we're going to make it. I'm still getting used to using the gears and remembering that I've got to switch into reverse and then drive forward normally using the accelerator. It's just a very different experience than how I had played FS19. I know there were mods out there for 19 to essentially implement a very similar gear system that we're using here, but I've always been the push forward to go forward, push back to go back kind of farm sim player. And so this has been a lot of fun kind of adjusting to a new way to drive around here. It does bring a little bit more realism, I feel like. I feel like it slows me down a bit in a good way, where I'm taking a little bit of a break to, you know, come to a complete stop, shift it into reverse, back up. I'm not quite in as much of an arcade mode when I'm playing Farm Sim. And so we're still adjusting. We're still getting used to it, but it's definitely gotten easier as we continue to knock out these episodes of Elm Creek here. So by the time we're through this series, I feel like we'll be in a much better spot. So I think we're gonna let the hired worker take over this job for me. And while this guy finishes putting the soybeans in here, oh, we're off by a row. We've got to get over here. But what I was going to say is while this guy finishes putting the soybeans in here, we've got to run up and get a little bit of spray for the sprayer. And we're going to need to get that run back up to the farm here. So we can definitely go do that and kind of get some more jobs done here while the seeding continues here. So let's go grab our truck and head on up to the store. All right, so we've got a thing of herbicide loaded up here as well as the liquid fertilizer. We're gonna need to spray our fields for both. We're probably gonna start, I think, with the fertilizer when we get going here. We've got a couple of fields left that need to get to that final stage of fertilization here. So I'm gonna hope that we can get through all of our fields with one container of each based on how far the herbicide went in the previous episodes here. I think we're gonna be fine on that front for sure. It's the liquid fertilizer I'm not as sure about, but we'll find out. We've got more fields, but I feel like we're already at the max stage here on a couple of them. So we're going to go ahead and just run this here back up into the yard. We're gonna be ready to start in on that fertilizer as soon as we're done with the seeding here. And so I'm looking forward to giving this thing a try. It's a cool looking mod. We've got the saddle tanks and everything here. So I'll park here and we'll get this stuff unloaded as soon as we're ready to start using it. And if we check back in here on our seeding tractor, and that sounds pretty good. I like it. We're getting the acres knocked out here. We've got, looks like one more pass over there. I think we're going to be able to wrap this up in the final pass. And I have to say, the workers, while they seem to have gotten a little bit dumber over time, he's been, or she's been, doing a pretty good job in this field. And they're not overlapping a ridiculous amount here as we go up and down the long rows. I always felt that in FS19, we had a ridiculous amount of overlap. And here, it seems like we're doing pretty good. We're straddling right close to that line there, so I'm liking that. And it does look like we're probably gonna miss maybe a row here on the outside. I feel like the work area on the seeder is slightly bigger than the seeder itself, but I'm not gonna come all the way back down the length of this field to get, you know, maybe a row here of crop. So this is our final pass here on the soybeans. And I'm looking forward to getting this sprayer set up. So let's go ahead and call this field completed. And I think we are going to disconnect this seeder here. Whoa, that was close. We almost lost the front of our tractor to that car, I feel like. We're gonna unfold and there we go. We'll disconnect this right here. There we go. I forgot we had manual attach on. I'm trying to figure out why I couldn't disconnect the seeder. Get out and do it the old fashioned way. I do wish that the game would save my reversing gear when I switch back and forth using the space bar. It seems to always put me in first gear here when I go back and forth. And I just noticed that there's no textures on that jack stand. So we'll just sneak down the headland here, get this brought back up into the yard, and get all switched over here for spraying. Ever since I saw this sprayer mod being released, I've been excited to try it out. It's a bit smaller than some of the base game sprayers, but it looks like it's gonna be a good fit here for the size of farm that we've got. So I'm gonna just put this cedar right here up along the barn, call that good, and we're gonna go get set up. I can't wait. All right, I know I was struggling with this in previous episodes, but the quick attach does work, or not the quick attach, the manual attach does work with these tanks. That was completely user error on my part last time when I was trying to get everything connected. So I'm excited that everything's working here. I know in FS19, I ran into lots of problems with using manual attach to the point where at some point I kind of got out of using it, even though historically I'd used it on almost all of my mods. And so I'm excited to kind of get back into using manual attach for most things in FS22. Now, I should have probably put this sprayer on first, as it looks like we're gonna clip through the arms here just a bit, but luckily there's no collision here, so we'll kind of blur our eyes a bit here for that. Now let's make sure, I'm trying to see if there's anything with hoses or anything. Doesn't look like there's a PTO or any hydraulics to hook up, so in theory we should be good to go here. Let's go ahead and raise this sprayer up like so. Now we're not clipping through the tanks. I like it. And now we just need to put a little bit of fertilizer in here to get us started. We're probably not even going to need the tanks, to be honest, but well, we have them, so let's give it a shot. Out of curiosity, we're going to start and try and fill the back tank up here first. So I'm going to assume that I can fill that from the rear, which is good. And it looks like I'm probably not going to be able to put that all into just that rear tank. I was kind of curious how big the rear tank is, a little over 1,000 liters. So you know what, rather than leave some of it laying around, we are going to switch up here to our side tanks and just put the rest of it up here. I can't remember how much is in a pallet. Is it 2,000? 2,000. So we've got, you know, almost half and half here between the two. That's all right. We're gonna get turned around here real quick and tackle the fields that we planted earliest with the fertilizer first. And so I believe that's gonna be field 46 over here, but let's take a quick look. So you can see here, field 46 is almost grown. All of these fields are grown fairly well. The only one that's still in an early stage is our soybeans that we literally just planted. And then if we take a look at the map here, you can see fields 44 and 46 both require fertilizing. And then I got to get rid of the weed display. Field 48 does as well. Now, weeds are interesting because with the way that weeds work, I think we actually sprayed herbicide on a few of these fields, which is why we don't have weeds there. Depending on what kind of tillage you do, I guess you can prevent weeds from growing. So if we'd actually plowed some of these fields, we shouldn't get weeds, which is something we're going to play with here next season. But we're going to start out with hitting fertilizer on 44, 46, and 48. And then we'll get switched over and spray some herbicide on those fields. Now, I'm pretty sure we're gonna be able to spray a little bit faster here. Just making sure our row crop tires are actually row crop tires and not destroying our field here as well. Looking good. So let's give this a shot and see how it's gonna work out. Oh no, I don't think we've got any spray effects on this sprayer. Well, that is a mite. I was gonna say a mite disappointing. I don't think it's actually spraying. Let's take a look here. Our spray is definitely not going down. So let me double check here. We are in a state where we need more fertilizer. Well, that's a mite disappointing here. We've got the noise for the sprayer. Let's move over here onto a different field and see if maybe we can get this to work. Maybe it's the stage that the crop is growing at, or maybe this sprayer is just not working out for us here. And on a whim, I decided to test. The sprayer just needed to be lowered. My bad, user error. Now that we got the sprayer lowered, you can see we've got the spray going into the field here, which is good. And we've got so many things going on here with the gears and such, we don't want to crash into any fences, so we're gonna get turned around here. And I believe the sprayer effects are now working as well, so it was just a matter of having to get the sprayer into the right mode in order to spray the fertilizer. I'm digging this, and as you can see, we're going, you know, 11 miles an hour here. We might get up to 12 off and on, depending on if we can get into the right gear. But with this field being so short, I just didn't have the mental capacity to get us going and get everything turned on and keep driving straight. So we're gonna have to take this thing out to the next field here and try that out, see if we can figure out what our top speed is while we're in the right gear. So we're here in 15th gear and we're able to go 13. If we go down to 14th gear, our max speed is 11. So we're gonna try this out as we take this pass down, just to see if we can get up over 11 miles an hour. I don't think we're going to be able to. I think 11's gonna be kind of our maximum spraying speed. I am digging this mod though. It's got some pretty cool animations on the arms and such, and yeah, it doesn't look like we're getting much over 10, 11 miles an hour, so we'll drop down a gear here and go with that. We get a lot better performance out of the tractor if we're in the appropriate gear, and we'll just cut back in here. I think this thing is gonna be about the perfect width to just do one round in these fields. I'm actually overlapping quite a bit off to the right side there. If we bring up the map though, you can see these are both now a nice dark blue. So we're gonna go ahead and fold this thing back up, remembering to raise it so that we don't crash into our tanks like last time. And as you can see, we've got some great animations here with the way these hydraulics work and the cables that suspend out to the wings. So I've been really enjoying playing with this mod today here so far. We're gonna jump over here now and hit field 48, I believe, which is the kind of second half of this combined field, and get a little bit of spray on that. And that should really wrap up our spraying here for at least the liquid fertilizer. Everything else is gonna be in a fertilized state, so we'll be able to switch over to herbicide in the near future and get that tackled after we're done with all of this spraying. So we're gonna start, I think, by just taking a headland pass off on this end, and then we'll go up and down the other way here like we did when we were seeding. I think that's gonna make the most sense for this field. Hopefully avoid going in the ditch. I'm still missing the mini map from Precision Farming and being able to see where I'm at from a spraying perspective here. It's really quite hard to kind of guess where you're going in these fields. So we're going to try though and cut through this way and just square things off. If I miss a little bit, we can always come back on the at the end on our way back up to the farm and fill in those gaps. I think I might have missed just a little bit on the angle there. Yep, we missed just a little bit, but that's all right. We're going to keep going with it this way and get the core chunk of the field sprayed. I don't want to be wasting lots of spray trying to clean up little bits until we're done with the core part of the field. It does look like we're gonna have plenty of spray though today. I think the hardest part with this is figuring out where to line back up. There's not a great amount of indicator, oh there it is, of where the sprayed part of the field is, and so I really need to get one of those GPS mods set up here. The vehicle control add-on, or I forget, there's another one out there that both have GPS like functionality, and so we're gonna have to sort that out here, because trying to do some of these jobs blindly without a GPS function, a little bit difficult. So we're gonna just not drive over all of our crops. We'll take the path back here to the other end and get that little bit that we missed at the angle, and that's gonna be all of our spraying here for today. Hopefully you've enjoyed today's episode. We're gonna be trying to bring in more and more new mods here as the modding community is starting to release a lot of things. So if you come across something cool that you think I should be using in the series, make sure to mention it in the comments of the video. However, that's all for today. Ketterk out. I've been excited to try it out. Oh, crash. Oh my goodness. All right, here we go. And so now that we've got the sprayer lowered, you can see that we are loading slowly.